But it was released in a not as useful format because it was released as data dump of the from the network. So it was just a result of TCP dump running for entire conquest. Here are some web pages from the system. Main pages is openbeacon.org. There is wiki there, and there are also addresses of the links for downloading datasets. There was some few pages with analysis data. Leica's Dream is project for visualizing positions of tags. It was used to during the Congress to visualize movement of all the participants that took part in the project. AMD, I will talk about it later, it was active during the Last Hope. And Social Patterns is quite new website. It is using the Sputnik system for analyzing social contacts, which means who is talking to whom and for how long. So this required slightly altering tags. So it was not active during the all congresses, but only during the last one. Few disclaimers, I'm not sociologist, so I'm from computer science department, so what I will be telling about this analysis is not pure science. So do not refer me for some scientific citations. The second disclaimer, I will talk about only about few examples, not all of them, and not all possible analysis methods of analyzing. So if you are interested, please talk to me later. And the second, thanks for all participants. I hope there are at least few there who were wearing these tags and were part of the project. Let's return with the first data set. It was during this Congress Sputnik was introduced, and data set had random numbers instead of IDs of tags. It was just problem with memory corruption. So not very good. I was trying to recover this by using internal characteristic of how tags are working. And I was not very successful in that. If you are more interested, talk to me later or go to my presentation from 24C3. This is how TAC sends the packets. In each packet, it sends ID of TAC, and it also sends value of ever-increasing counter. The counter increases once per every packet sent. So it should mean that packet is that each TAC is this is a linear function that can be counted, that can be plot time versus value of this counter. Because TAC sends packets regularly. Unfortunately, for many TACs, this is how it looked like. I'm afraid that some TACs were broken, or maybe their owners were playing too much with them. In this way, there is no proper linear sequence of counter values. This is another example. This is even worse, because here we have almost no linear, no straight line. And my trials of recovering of lost IDs were assuming that tags are behaving properly, which means that they are sending increasing counter values. And I'm afraid this is why I have not succeeded in recovering those IDs, because large portion of the old talks from the next conference, which during which we had proper IDs, proper data set, were showing this behavior. And if we assume that the tags during the previous congress were behaving similarly, it means that that there is no there is little chance of recovering this data set. So currently, unfortunately, I do not know how to recover this data set. And there is no much need for that, as we have more data sets from later congresses. So this first data set can be only seen as some kind of historical value for the first Sputnik project. This is also kind of strange sequence, because in the counter, there should not be going back, because back in sequence values, because there is even no such code inside the firmware. I analyzed every line of it, so I have not noticed that there is some error. So I'm not sure what to think about this, whether it was some kind of spoofing of tags or replay attack or something like that. But there were only two such cases, like here. Okay, for data format. There was ordinary CSV text file with spaces between values. There was tag ID, Unix timestamp when this packet was received, ID of station that received it, strength of the signal, because tags were sending signals of varying strength to allow for better position estimation, value of counter, which was described by me just before, and flag. Flag is currently only used to detect whether user pressed the button or not. This is summary of the first useful data set. 200 tags. The difference is that tags were sending packets more than once per second. During the previous congress, it was sending packets once every few seconds. And large increase in number of stations. When I uploaded it into my database, it was almost 2 gigabytes of data plus some indexes for faster access. So it is rather large data set. For the last hope, those are positions of readers. Here is the heaven, so this is a place for volunteers. No ordinary attendees were allowed here, so it will be important later. Here is the basement. So the lounge, hackerspace, and so on. Here is the base level. Here is cafeteria. Here was the Sputnik booth. Here are the lecture rooms. And here is the highest floor. Here is the biggest lecture room. And here were some stand-ups of Wikipedia and things like that. This is just statistical data. As